Hello everybody, how are you? This is Andrea and welcome to a new Face Up Stories, where I show you how I repaint a doll from start to finish. Today's doll has been hiding in my drawer for about 4 years. She is a Latidoll Yellow Suji head, and I got her as a bonus event head with my Lati Yellow twins. Maybe you even remember the unboxing video that I made back in 2013. Man, it feels like decades ago. At that time, I was still accepting commissions regularly. But basically, I never did anything with her, and because I am now going through some reshuffling of my doll family, it was about time to decide what to do with this head. I did not want to just sell her. I thought that it at least deserved a face-up since it's been with me for so long. Today's face-up relies heavily on an airbrush. I mean, you can definitely achieve similar results with pastels, but it is just so much faster and easier to use an airbrush. As you've seen, I started with some general peach blushing around her face to make it less flat. And now I am airbrushing the eyeshadow. I use blue, purple, pink, and yellow watercolor paint. The airbrush blends the colors really well, and as you can see, it creates beautiful gradients. Just look at the pink to yellow gradient. It totally looks like I've manually added some reds and oranges as well, when in reality it is just pink and yellow. Today I am using Holbein watercolors with my Iwata airbrush. I will leave all the info and links to the stores in the description box. Also, don't forget that before you start painting a doll, it has to be properly prepped with the correct sealant. Otherwise, the materials won't show up on the plastic material. I explain in detail my sealing method in the brush on sealants video. And if you're new to this hobby, have a look at my Back to Basics video to become familiar with the materials and tools to repaint dolls. Okay, back to the video. I've been slowly adding details using both pencils and pastels. Now it is time for the eyelashes and some more blushing. While that is happening, here are this month's 3 Instagram features. If my videos have inspired you, don't forget to tag me using the hashtag AndreaTutorials. Every month I pick 3 people to be featured in one of my videos. Okay, time for some glitter for our rainbow girl. Let's also add some lashes, eyelashes. If you want a detailed explanation about this, I have a video all about it in my Back to Basics series. Also, you can buy doll eyelashes from most doll online stores, but eBay and Etsy have plenty as well. The very last step for this face-up is gloss. I apply some on the lips and lower lash line. And here is the finished face-up. But don't run away yet, we still have some stuff to do. I think she needs some special eyes to go with the face up. Luckily, I just received a package from Sprouty Doll, where she sent me some eyes and some awesome eye making tools and materials from her online store. Let's check these eyes out, shall we? We have 3 different colors, one blue, one peach pink, and one rainbow. Let me know which one of the 3 you like the most. And as we are enjoying the eye candy, excuse the pun, I want to say big thanks to the community on Patreon who have kindly brought to you this video. It is also thanks to their support that I am putting together a special giveaway for YouTube. I will release more info when we hit the 500,000 mark, so it will be a milestone celebration / YouTube giveaway. It will be the biggest giveaway I've ever done, so massive hugs to my generous patrons. Okay, so as you can see, I picked the rainbow eyes for her. Now let's give her some clothes. I will stick to white just to balance out all the other colors on her face. Wig time! I've been obsessed with lavender and lilac so much, I just can't help myself. And here is her final look. I hope that you like her just as much as I do. Even though the face-up looked quite saturated on its own, it looks much softer with the wig and everything, don't you agree? So yeah, this is all I have for today. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, comment and share. And if this was your first time on my channel, I would love to have you subscribed so you don't miss out on any future videos. Thank you so much for watching, take care, and I'll talk to you again really soon. Bye!